morning to all. In today's section, we discuss about air pollution control. In this, we discuss about the different air pollution control devices and air pollution control methods. In air pollution control, we discuss the particulate pollution control and gaseous pollution control. First, we discuss detail regarding the particulate matter pollutant. Particulate matter is a sum of all solid and liquid particles suspended in the air, many of which are hazardous. The complex mixture contains instance dust, pollen, soot, smoke, and liquid droplets. These are five major processes to control this type of particulate matter. Particulate matter controlling methods are mainly five processes. That is, first one, settling chamber. Second one, inertial separator or cyclone separator. Third one, electrostatic precipitator. Fourth one, bikehouse or filters. And last one, wet scrubbers. By using these five different methods, we can control this particulate matter pollution. First, we discuss the settling chamber. Settling chamber is a simple device collecting dust of size above 10 micrometer. Settling chambers use the force of gravity to remove solid particles. The gas stream enter a chamber. That's a process behind the settling chamber. The gas stream enter to a particular chamber where the velocity of gas is reduced. Large particle droplets, particles drop out of the gas and are recollected in a hopper. Because the settling chamber are effective in removing only large particles, they are used in conjunction with the more efficient control devices. The size, shape of particles are particles and density and viscosity are important parameter for this using a settling chamber. Settling chamber is a chamber that collect there is this shape structure and how it based on the gravity force of the earth we settle the particles. This is the picture of settling chamber. This show that there's a particular option is there, the dust collecting hope is there, gas inlet is there, gas outlet, and there are collecting dust collection hoppers. The second type of controlling device is the inertial separator or cyclone separator. This type of development are this type of air pollution control device are developed due to the research in environmental engineering. In this process is achieved by the sudden change in the direction of gas flow. The dust particle is spinning in a circular path. It is subject to an outward force. As a result, the particle collected on the wall and fall to the bottom of the vessels. This is a picture of cyclone separator. So force, there is a gas is coming, a rotating force, and it is due to this rotation, the particles, materials are adhered to the surface and is loosed off. That's a process. Next equipment used to control air pollution is the electrostatic precipitator. Passing the particle laden gases between high voltage discharge electrodes. Majority of the particles get charged and collected on the ground electrodes. At intervals, both the discharge and the collecting electrode are tried to dislodge collected particles from the electrodes, which then fall into hopper at the bottom of the precipitator. The electrostatic precipitator is efficient for the particle size below 0.01 micrometer. It is very useful in the fine dust collecting or controlling the fine particles. Can tolerate operating temperature as high as 700 degree Kelvin. These are the pictures showing the electrostatic precipitator. You have electrodes are there. In between the electrodes, we pass through the gaseous substance, and due to this electric charge particle, this is settled down the electrode. Next type of collector controlling devices are baghouse and filters. This method is most often used type of device which is required to meet any future standards limiting the emission of respirable particles. The collection efficiency is very high, and even for particles of 0.01 micron diameter collected, the fabric filters or baghouse remove dust from the gas stream by passing the stream through a porous fabric. Nowadays we use masks to control this type of particular prevent coronavirus. This is a type of filter. The fabric filter is efficient at removing fine particles and can exceed efficiencies of 99% in most applications. This is a picture showing electrostatic. Sorry, this is going filter, back filter. Next equipment that control air pollution is a wet scrubber. The objective of scrubber is to entrain the particle matter in a liquid droplet. Water subsequently flows from bottom of the scrubber. The particulate is allowed to settle and clarified water is recirculated. That means once water is sprayed from the top and dirty gas is passed from the bottom or sidewall, it will the water that react contact with the particulate matter and will settle down to the bottom. This is a picture showing. The removal method of gaseous pollutants are designed to concentrate the pollutants in a liquid, that is absorption, or a solid, that means adsorption. The absorption of the concentrate the pollutant designed to, there are two terms, is in a liquid, that is called absorption, or a solid, it is called adsorption. Sometimes direct conversion of gaseous pollutant is possible by combustion. There are mainly three methods to remove this gaseous pollutant. We already discussed the removal method of particulate pollutant. The removal method of gaseous pollutant are designed to concentrate the pollutant in the liquid, that is absorption, or the concentration in a solid is called adsorption. First we discuss what is absorption. Absorption is a process is selected to remove gaseous pollutant by dissolving into a liquid solvent such as water or in a caustic or acid solution. Most commonly water is used as an absorbent. As the gas stream passes through the liquid absorbs the gas. Absorption is commonly used to recover product or to purify gas stream that have high concentration of organic compounds. Among several considerations in absorption unit design, the most important is the selection of a suitable liquid solvent and determination of the limit of the absorption efficiency. Selection of appropriate equipment for liquid gas contact and capital cost of the unit. These are the different considerations among the installation of absorption plants. Second is the adsorption. Adsorption is a process where gaseous vapors or liquid are concentrated on a solid surface as a result of surface or chemical force. Chemical force means that is a physical absorption and a chemical absorption are there. The amount of absorbed substance depend directly on the internal surface area of the solid and the kinetic of the process. That means simply adsorption is the process of removing the gaseous pollutant or adsorbing a solid surface or reactive surface. Absorption means it is absorbed in a liquid. The most important adsorbent in industrial use today are bauxite, activated carbon, activated alumina, silica gel and molecular sieves are used for the purpose of adsorption. The third method of controlling is a combustion. That means to burning out. This method for the removal of volatile organic compounds, since they can be decomposed to carbon dioxide and water. The direct and indirect or catalytic methods are used for the combustion process. The catalytic method is preferred when low temperature of the process is desired. The commonly used catalysts CuNi, nickel, V and zinc compounds. If the concentration of the air pollutant are high, a combination of sorption method and catalytic reaction is used. In this three different class, we discuss about what is air pollution, air pollutant, what are the issues, health issues of air pollution, and then what are the different methods to control air pollution. This topic is very important in relation to the control of air pollution. The major concern in environmental engineering is to reduce the air pollution and increase the quality of the life. Thank you.